In 3, 2. Hey, Chemical Guys family. Thanks so much for tuning in for today's episode of Detail Garage. Have you guys ever wondered what's the best way to clean your leather, or if you just looked around your vehicle and saw all those nasty stains? So today we brought in this actor to show you guys how to properly care for your leather seats and interior, because over time they collect a lot of grease, a lot of staining, and this also dries out the leather, which gives you this cracking look, and also over time it's going to start tearing. So we're going to start by using leather cleaner, and what this does is it gently cleans any kind of leather goods, whether you're working on your interior of your car, your house, maybe some leather clothing, and all you have to do is simply spray it onto a horsehair brush. And this is a gentle bristle, which is safe for leather goods so it doesn't scratch the surface, because it's just a piece of hide or a piece of skin and that can damage very easily. Now we're going to scrub to help agitate and activate the suds. This will help to lift off any of those deep stains or any kind of lingering odors. And it's okay to get it in the perforated holes of the seat. It'll dry up and you'll easily wipe it away. But I'll show you a trick for when you go to the protection stage to prevent any kind of clotting. We see the foaming action. This is helping to remove any of that grease or any kind of jean stains or anything you might have accumulated. Working it back and forth to revive that like new look and feel. And just to show you guys what we're actually pulling off the surface, we'll take a clean yellow workhorse microfiber towel. And the reason why we're using yellow is because this will show you any kind of dirt that you pull off of the surface, but it also helps to coordinate your detailing job so you're not bringing, you know, exterior towels into the interior, but you see all this nastiness from the seat. But that's going to help you prevent any kind of cross-contamination. All that, there's just hiding in the gray leather of the seat here. So the same process goes for whether you're working on door panels or any kind of other leather seat or upholstery. Simply spray the brush. You can also spray the surface and then just gently scrub away any of the filth that was clotting up the surface. And the reason why you want to clean it is because it's going to make it easier for any kind of coating or any kind of protectants to bond to the surface. This will give you a better chance of a longer lasting protectant, and it also helps to basically rejuvenate the surface itself. Same process for scrubbing back and forth, side to side, kind of like a cross-hatching pattern. So you're getting all the nooks and crannies. And just a pro tip is always to wear gloves, especially when you're working on interior surfaces, because interiors are very dirty and it's also very hard to see what you're cleaning. So it's just a good idea, a pro tip, to wear gloves to protect yourself. Wipe away any of the spent product, any of the dirt. We've also already vacuumed the seat to make sure that we're not grinding any kind of food or particles or anything into the crevices of the seat or into the pores of the seat. You see all the dirt that was sitting inside of there. Now we're going to move on to the protection stage. We're going to use some leather conditioner. And a lot of people ask us, is it necessary to condition your seats even if there's a type of protectant on there? And the answer is yes, because this is going to add a barrier between the surface of the seat and also anything that comes in contact with it. That includes your jeans or spills. And also, if your car sits outside a lot, this helps to rejuvenate it and also protect it, because you can think of this as like a lotion for your leather. And if your car sits in direct sunlight or in extreme harsh elements and heat, you want to use something like leather serum, which is like sunscreen for your leather. So what we're going to do is start by shaking the bottle up. This will mix together all the nutrients, the vitamin E, everything that your seats and leather products need to last as long as possible. We're using a tan applicator pad, because we've designated this for leather jobs. And now for seats that have a lot of perforation or stitching, or maybe it has a two-tone effect, what I like to do is I'll take it on the applicator and then I'll spread it out with my finger. This way we're not putting a heavy buildup in one area. And this will prevent any kind of clotting. So you can dab it out and then just start spreading it into the surface. And this will start bonding immediately, so there's no real need to let it sit for too long. You can leave it like this and let it dry, or for more of a natural look, just take a clean microfiber towel and wipe off any of the excess. So. So again, we'll use a yellow workhorse towel. You can also use a tan towel for working on your leather goods. Just buff off the spent product, any of the excess, to reveal that natural look. And this is a process that you can repeat as often as desired, or at least once every 3 months to kind of keep up on the cleaning and also the protection of your leather goods and your upholstery. So again, it can last as long as possible and look its best. So guys, if you want to learn more about these products, head over to our website, chemicalguys.com, or to your local detail garage. If you liked today's video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, drop your comments down below for future videos, and we'll see you guys next time.